And it seemed like from these storms and paying attention to what you guys are telling the viewers, what the National Weather Service says, and that's going to really come in handy as we expect some severe weather in the next few days, right?
Yeah, that's right. You know, things are calm now as the severe threat has passed, and we're going to look ahead to a really nice Sunday coming up for us, but we're already looking ahead. We have our eye on another system coming in on Tuesday. It could bring us plenty of strong storms on the way for that as well. So it's already, we've been warning you and talking about it for the past few days now about this next system that approaches on Tuesday. Again, to recap the location of those confirmed tornadoes, 7 of them, 4 coming out of the north central portion of Indiana, EF0 to EF1 tornadoes, all the way north of Crawfordsville, stretching over to Tipton and beyond. And then, of course, the storms and the tornadoes that swept across, going through Bargersville, Whiteland. EF2 tornado reported here. We saw roofs of houses completely lifted in some portions of Whiteland. And then, of course, to the south here, the EF3 tornado that leveled an entire block of houses. I remember last night when we got that first report in that the one house had been destroyed there completely in Sullivan, over there in Sullivan County, just to the south in the Wabash Valley. And then right after that, it was okay, a block of houses are now. And then after that, we learned that there were going to be rescue crews literally going from door to door, just looking for people that were trapped and looking for people that may have survived from that tornado. So we talked about a lot of the winds from last night and the damage. And so just to put some of those pictures that we showed you earlier in the newscast into perspective, some of those winds, 83 miles per hour reported here. This is going to be from severe winds, lasted about 8 minutes of duration, where the winds did meet severe criteria, reported at 83 miles per hour. That was over near Martinsville. And then we also saw reports, this is near the airport, that reported a 65 mile per hour wind gust, 67 there as well on the southwest side of Indianapolis. And if you remember that picture we just showed you, Max just had it pulled up, of the gas station where the roof actually toppled over. This was where it happened, right here. And the thunderstorm winds that downed the gas station overhanging roof, estimated time around 11:55 p.m. last night. That was just some of the many storm reports, not only from Indiana, but across the Midwest as severe weather moved through. 39 degrees right now in Indianapolis. It moved along a cold front, so temperature is now cooling down quite a bit, and it actually feels like we're below freezing in Indianapolis at 31 degrees. The next few hours, what happens a lot of times, these storms move through, severe weather, cold front, and then you get clearing, you get sunshine. Tomorrow, that's what we have, sunshine coming our way for Sunday, and we'll start to warm things up as we head to the beginning of next week, just preparing for our next system. Temperatures right now into the upper 30s and some of the lower 40s, especially around Bloomington, where the winds are now calming down, 15 miles per hour. But even today, after the storms, when we started to dry things out, these are peak wind gusts from today, 52 miles per hour in Indianapolis, 51 in Terre Haute, 49 in Columbus, 67 there in Muncie. So we actually had that wind advisory across the state that did get elevated a bit to that high wind warning for today. Now that has all dropped. We're not looking at any severe or wind, no criteria there to talk about. But going into the start of next week, we're going to be looking ahead to Tuesday, especially Tuesday night into Wednesday, as our next system could be bringing strong to potentially even severe storms. So we'll certainly be continuing to forecast that as we get closer and closer. But once again, make sure you have a way to get those weather updates with us. We'll be staying and covering those storms live if need be. Temperature is going to be hanging out in the 70s as we get into the middle of next week. Alyssa.